Hello student, today I am going to discuss principle of conservation of momentum. What is momentum? Motion contained in a body is called momentum. If the body is in motion, body has momentum. If the body has rest, momentum is zero. What is the statement of principle of conservation of momentum? It states that the total momentum, linear momentum of a system is constant if the net external force acting on the system is zero. If no force acting on the system, then momentum remains constant. That is the statement of principle of conservation of momentum. As we know, according to Newton's second law of motion, F equal to dp by dt, that is the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the applied force, F equal to dp by dt. If external force F equal to zero, then dp by dt equal to zero. So if since differentiation is zero, means P is constant, a constant vector. So a constant vector, P is a constant vector, means this is P is momentum, P represent momentum, so momentum is constant. Now we are going to proof of principle of conservation of momentum. We are going to prove for an isolated system, the initial momentum of the system is equal to the final momentum of the system. To prove this, we are taking two bodies, body A, other is body B, moving with velocity U1 and U2. They will get collision if E1 is greater than U2. That is, before collision and during collision, they will be contact to each other. This is during collision. And they will separate to each other if V1 is less than V2, that is after collision, velocity V1, V2, mass M1, M2, here also mass M1, M2. So we are considering two bodies A and B of masses M1, M2, moving with initial velocities U1, U2. Respectively along a straight line. So they will get collision if E1 is greater than U2. So after collision, velocity of the two bodies becomes V1 and V2 in the same direction respectively. The rate of change of momentum of the body, momentum of body A after collision, change in momentum, so this is M1, M2, V1 minus E1 by T, the rate of change of momentum. आफ्टर रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम बॉडी ए आफ्टर कोलिशन. सिमिलरली द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम ऑफ द बॉडी बी आफ्टर कोलिशन बी टू माइनस यू टू अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. न्यूटन सेकेंड लॉ वी नो एफ ए बी एम वन वी वन माइनस वी टू वी वन माइनस ई वन डिवाइड बाई टी एंड एफ बी ए फोर्स एक्टिंग बॉडी बी ड्यू टू बॉडी ए न्यूटन सेकेंड लॉ एम टू बी टू माइनस यू टू डिवाइड बाई टी. अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ मोशन अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन वी गेट एफ ए बी इक्वल टू माइनस एफ बी ए टू एवरीबॉडी इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट reaction. Now we are putting the value FAB M1 B1 minus E1 divided by T equal to minus M2 B2 minus U2 divided by T. So both side TT cancel M1 B1 minus E1 माइनस एम टू बी टू माइनस यू टू एम वन भी वन नाउ मल्टीप्लाइड एम वन भी वन माइनस एम वन ई वन मल्टीप्लाइड माइनस एम टू भी टू माइनस माइनस प्लस एम टू यू टू. सो एम वन भी वन this is minus bring left side plus m2 v2 equal to so minus m1 e1 we are taking my right side m2 so now we are bringing left side so it's m1 v1 plus m2 v2 or we can write sorry this m1 b1 we are bringing this minus 1 left side so plus m2 b2 equal to now this one we transfer right side m1 e1 plus m2 u2. Now we can write m1 e1 plus m2 u2 equal to m1 b1 plus m2 v2. This is the two total momentum of two bodies before collision is equal to the total momentum of the two bodies after collision. So this statement, this is the statement of principle of conservation of momentum. Total momentum before collision, total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum of two bodies after collision, which is the proof of principle of conservation of momentum. Thank you.